This video on tutorial of basics of IR sensor. IR sensor or the infrared sensor actually come in two packs, as we can see. One is the RX and one is the TX. Also, they come in various packages size, like this is the 5mm package and this is the 3mm package. They differ in size. They are not up to scale as visible over here, but still we can manage to see. At least now we can see that there are color differences between the RX and the TX. Now basically RX and TX, as they say, are the receiving and the transmitting LEDs. The transmitter actually transmit rays in infrared spectrum, and the RX is designed to receive those IR spectrum rays. As we can see that the IR receiver is more darker in color and the transmitter is like a transparent. Similarly, the another package that is available in market, here we have the transmitter in slightly blue shaded color while the receiver is completely transparent. So this was how an IR transmitter receiver pair looks like. Let us move forward to the working principle of an IR sensor. Now, as just we said that an IR LED, that is the transmitter, can actually transmit in infrared spectrum. In the infrared spectrum, whenever a voltage is given between its terminals, it is just a diode, but it emits rays whenever a specific voltage is given between its two terminals, that is the cathode and the anode. So we have a transmitter that we saw over here, a receiver as we saw, and the principle actually behind the working of an IR sensor is the reflectivity of by an object. Now, whenever we have any object in front of a transmitter, the object tends to reflect the rays that is coming from the IR sensor to back to the IR sensor. So actually, you by using this principle, we can like use this IR transmitter receiver pair for detecting objects. And how do we do that? Whenever a ray that is reflected by an object is received by the receiver, it generates a voltage level at its across its terminal, and this voltage level depends upon the intensity of the light that is reflected by the object. We will further discuss about what intensity level and what voltage level we mean over here. So let us move forward to our first example, where we have a transmitter and a receiver placed side by side. Now we can see that the IR transmitter, it's transmitting within a limited range, and it goes to a certain distance. Actually, IR transmitters are not so powerful that it can traverse great distances, but still it can manage at least a few centimeters for detection purpose. We also have a receiver over here. This is actually a very sensitive type of receiver, not a common type of receiver. Now, as there is no object present over here, so there is no reflection, and that is where no object has been detected. So, also, the output between the terminals of the receiver IR LED will be like 0 volt. Now we move towards another example where we have the object present in front of the IR transmitter. Here we can see that the rays have been reflected and some of the rays can be captured by the IR receiver. Now this will in turn generate some voltage and we will have an object detected. Though it may not give the accurate distance of the object, but still it can manage to give the desired output, that is detecting an object in its vicinity. Now let us move to another example. Here actually we can see that whenever there is a brighter object, like a completely white screen, it reflects more of the rays. Whenever we have a black screen, it reflects very much less than the previous one. It reflects, but still the quantity is too less to be detected by the IR receiver. That means if a brighter screen is there, it will reflect more. If a darker screen is there, it will reflect less in the IR range. So using this principle, actually, we can make a line follower which will track a bright line or a black line depending upon whatever we want. Suppose we want a black line, then we will program it that whenever the IR receiver will receive the most lesser amount of the rays, that means the lower voltages, it will follow there only. Suppose we want to the IR robotic vehicle to track a brighter line, that is a white line, then we will have larger voltages across the receiver. So we will be getting the brighter rays and following it with a larger voltages across the terminals. The voltage levels can be compared with comparators or various other techniques using microcontrollers, etc. So this was how the IR sensor works. Thank you.